Blackstone presents Killing Adonis by J.M. Donellan. This book is read by Jodie Harris. Dedication. For my father, who was thankfully nothing at all like Harland Vincetti. Section 1. Medical History. Shall we begin by taking it as a general principle that all disease, at some period or other of its course, is more or less a reparative process? Florence Nightingale, Notes on Nursing, What It Is and What It Is Not. Chapter 1. Cakewalking. I hate this song. Freya, you didn't answer my question. I'll take a Moscow mule. Cheers. A disapproving frown fills Jane's face. I didn't ask if you wanted another drink, Frey. I asked if you're serious about this. Yeah, I heard you. I was hoping I could change the subject. Look, I don't want to think of it so much as giving up on my lifelong dreams of working for the Red Cross in East Timor as embracing my backup dream of sitting on the couch getting fat watching Seinfeld reruns. East Timor will still be there in a year or two. Unless Indonesia forcefully reclaims it, I suppose. But this is what you've been working towards, what you always said you were going to do. 4 years' experience in a local hospital, then a job in East Timor. You bored us all to death talking about it. I get that you're upset about what happened to Valerie. Freya winces at the mention of Valerie's name, images of blood and steel ricocheting through her head. No, you don't get it at all. If I had a religion to lose then, I would be losing it right now. What happened to Val was... Christ, you know what? We've been over this. If I start talking about it again, I'm just going to end up the weird girl crying in the bar that everyone looks at. Let's talk about something else. You want another drink? Vodka and Coke. Easy on the vodka. Got it. Freya moves through the crowd of bleary-eyed early evening revelers. The air is a sweltering haze of foul-smelling smoke and ear-wrenchingly bad American electro noise. It sounds like a drunken tattoo artist singing karaoke over the glitchy bleeping of an ancient Commodore 64 computer. On nights like this, the clouds of colour swimming in front of her eyes are usually more a source of entertainment than annoyance, but right now, their buzzing and bouncing greatly vexes her. She ignores the little Kandinskys dancing in her vision and walks inside. She passes through the doors of Rick's for, what, the 10 millionth time? How many hazy, drunken nights has she begun, regretted, and then repeated here? Too many to count. She checks her reflection in the glass and is as satisfied as she ever allows herself to be. A curtain of crimson hair frames her elegant cheekbones and kryptonite green eyes. She would like to be a little thinner, she supposes. Her tight red dress, paired with matching red gloves, displays her curves that are teetering between femininely seductive and a little more to love. But if she lost any more weight, she could hardly criticize the waif-like creatures on TV and, more to the point, filling this bar with half as much vitriol. And she enjoys doing that. She stands at the bar waiting for the Barbie doll ahead of her to finish her mating dance with the bartender. When the girlish tittering and batting of eyelids goes on for too long, she says, "Hey, Twinkle Toes, when you're done staring down at that fake blonde's fake breasts, you want to rustle me up a couple of drinks? I'll take a Moscow mule, heavy on the Moscow, and a vodka and Coke, heavy on the part that isn't Coke."
"Hey, sweetheart, I'll serve you these, but after that, you'd better slow down."
"Sorry, nosebleed. I have a strict policy of not taking advice from anyone who has brand name tattoos on his neck."
"Nosebleed? Shit, is my..."
"Not yet. It's a preemptive nickname. Call me sweetheart one more time and it'll suddenly be highly applicable."
"Jesus, I was just being friendly."
"You and Merriam-Webster have very different interpretations of friendly. Now hurry up with that booze. I've got a future I need to avoid thinking about." The bartender complies with a grimace. Freya grins at him and walks back outside, holding...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.